In the bottom of our hearts, we all want a small mustache. Exactly. A stash has power. Blackbirds and night rooks. Are they anything dangerous? I don't know. Let's try confusing them, though. Need to shave. Yeah, it's actually getting to the time of year where I stop shaving and grow out the hobo beard for the holidays. Hey, we've bewildered some things. One of them laughed hysterically. This bird just like cackling. That's horrifying. Worked a whole year to grow a nice beard and succeeded. Hell yeah. Wow, Rove killed something by dealing a point of damage with a whip. That's pretty impressive. Swell's head with an oversized handlebar mustache and wheels. I mean, you're right on with the oversized handlebar mustache. The biggest, most ridiculous mustache you can imagine. Is he near 36? I'm gonna actually start dumping some points into his theology until he hits the next spell level. It's like, yeah, like, that'll be useful once he gets back into Lord. And then when he's in Lord, I'm probably gonna start dumping it into diplomacy again. More throwing skill for Ela. Oratory and Kirijutsu. Let's go ahead and save here. Let's maybe get some nappy time in, get everybody's stamina back up. It feels like random encounters in this, like in general, wandering are higher, but random encounters when we're sleeping don't seem to be too bad, thankfully. All right, I'm gonna have Sin and Ela magic missile the shit out of the back row. I'm gonna have Goldleaf try to blind them. And I should play Dungeon Master 2 again. That was a good time. Chunk stealing stash marshmallow off of Swell's face and smearing the sticky mats on his blades as a poison attack. Good lord. I just imagine like Ela then trying to get some of it to smear on like Goldleaf's feet or something. Is that a fetish? A mustache full of ants and wasps. Sin just nuked the party. God damn it. I still keep forgetting. I keep forgetting to try his bardic stuff. See if it works. Alright, this round we're gonna do. Alright, Sin, use the angel tongue, because that's a damage boost. Well, let's see if this works. Thing ran. God damn it. No, he played it though. All right, cool. So he can still use his music. Hell yeah. Okay, bump up that. Bump up. We're gonna just start dumping points into skin. No. We're gonna dump. We gotta max out swimming before we plop points into other things. Happy Ghost is not allowed to have nice things until everybody in the party can swim good. Alright, Chunk. I'm sorry. Oh, it hurts. And the downside is I don't think he has... Yeah, he has, like, no armor in the wings. Oh, no, he's got suede armor. Okay. Less butthurt and a basilard that I don't think he's gonna use, actually. We'll just drop that. And I think the Ankh of Life is class neutral, yeah. Alright! Chunk is... The entire party now has multi-class. Everybody's bad. Thankfully, the casters in back are capable of kind of carrying us. I do want to check really quick. 100. 100. 100. And the reason I want to check is there's an area I want to poke around in. 100. 100. All right, everybody's got maxed out swimming. We gotta go back. Back to the Babby newbie area. Got mods. Everybody's bad, let the fun begin, yes. Now is time to get that new player experience. It won't be that bad, because I mean, like, the casters have got levels on them, so we've at least got spells to lean on. But yes, he can still punch things, and he'll be able to pick locks better, and, like, basically all of his thieving levels, like, yeah, see, he's still doing the same amount of damage with his punches. He's just gonna have more trouble penetrating damage reduction on things, because for whatever reason in this, that scales with your level? I don't know. Thankfully, at this point in the game, I don't think it's gonna really matter that much. Just fight these guys. Yula tries to sneaky smear them on Goldie's feet. Rose just used a paying her to smear stash mallow. Oh my god. Oh no. Poor Goldleaf. Leave her alone. That poor woman. She puts up with so much. She's probably thought about killing every member in this party in their sleep. Maybe except for Swell. She likes Swell. But she's just so tired of everybody else's shit. I imagine Chunk probably leaves her alone. I imagine, realistically, outside of murdering things, Chunk probably doesn't really care about a whole hell of a lot. Priest level... I will take that 1 point in Oratory. That's a kick in the dick. Another level of Cleric spells, though, which... Conjuration! We remember Conjuration being good. Superman is also really good. If I recall correctly, it's like a crazy damage buff. It's one that you want. I know that much. What do we got? Fire, magic, water, Superman. Fight with the power and finesse of a hero. Okay, that tells me literally nothing, Manuel. Thank you. Allow me to pull up the website that contains actual useful game information. Wizardry 7. Magic. Superman. What's it do? All right. Looks like plus one to damage per level, minus one to AC, plus one to hit, and plus two to initiative per level. So it's basically a buff for everything. An incredibly, incredibly good buff. I think they called it Superman because in ye olde D&D, there's the heroism spell. And you used to be able to find potions of heroism. You could also find potions of superheroism. And I think that's what the Superman spell, the naming convention there is. Not a single random encounter yet. What is this? Aside from a save and a nap. Else you everything, you fight like a hero. I mean, at cap, at 7th level, it's plus 7 to damage, minus 4 AC, plus 4 to hit, plus 14 to your initiative. Gank and sleep? Nothing, we're fine. Alright, save and resume. I save the game, and there's the attack. Alright, fair play. Sounds like Tensor's transformation. Yeah, basically. Basically, except you cast it on somebody else. If you cast it on Elan, you'd actually probably be doing pretty decent damage. Because he attack, well, not right now, once he gets some levels on him. Because he makes, since he two-weapon fights, he gets a shitload of attacks. So like, a plus 5 to damage, and if he's attacking, you know, 6 times around, that's 30 damage. Like, that's nothing to sneeze at. Tensor's transformation is bad. Well, yeah. But this is like a Tensor's transformation on a character that actually wants it. Guards have lived for way too long. Let's solve that problem. Broke into a house to nap. Oh man. Quest for Glory as a Thief. That man, those games were so good. Like, those are some of the only adventure games that, like, I look back on fondly. The first four, anyways. I wasn't a huge fan of Quest for Glory 5. Man, Quest for Glory 4, like, I think is probably my favorite adventure game. Like, I can't think of any off the top of my head that I would consider to be a better adventure game. Like, it's just a legitimately good game. Okay, I think it was down here with all the dandafoots and bambafoots. All right, save. Let's have a nappy, make sure everybody's got stamina. Quest for Glory 4 is so good. Like, damn. So, so good. Good music, the game's beautiful to look at. Like, it's interesting to play. 4 glow moths, a cost chunk. We immediately cast Wake Up on Rove. Yeah, and like, that's the other thing, is it's really cool to basically be able to take a character from the first game all the way through to the end. And like, the stuff that you've done in previous games in some cases carries forward and stuff. It's just really cool. Just a really cool series. There's, the newer games, I think they're called Heroine's Quest? That, to my understanding, are kind of like going for the old Quest for Glory stuff. I've not played them, but to my understanding, they are also very good. All right, save again. Nap so that people wake up. All right, so we step into the water. You can see that took a chunk out of our stamina. It's basically for every 10 points of swimming, you can move a square in water. So since we have 10 swimming, we can move 10 squares before everybody's out of stamina, and if your stamina runs out, you die. Because video games. There are some areas where we will have, like, boats and stuff. Not so much here. So we also have to be careful actually fighting enemies, because fighting uses stamina, and if you run out of stamina, you die. Why is max swimming barely better than real life swimming skill? I don't know, but I'm sorry. This is gonna be a problem here momentarily. Is there something over there? I don't know if we can actually, like, I don't wanna save. This is where I kind of wish I had rest all. Oh yeah, we can cast stamina. 5 stamina. 5 cast stamina. 5 stamina. 5 stamina. This is, oh man, this is quality. I would say, yeah, we're fucked. We're fucked. We're fucked. We reload. We reload. Okay, so we saw that there was something down and to the right. One, two, three, four, yeah. Two, three, four, uh-oh. Floaters! They make a return. I don't know if these are the nasty ones or not.
You float face down, scares down.
Oh my god. That's funny. Oh yeah, this is not a good fight. These are the nasty ones. They do all of the every. Oh, they fly away. We can also check out. There's that fountain in town. We kill any of them. We killed two, or at least two decided to fuck off. Maybe try a fireball. That's some damage. All right. And they're just going for gold leaf. Loader shoots tentacle. I don't even want to know. Jelly stingers. Okay. They're terrible. Good experience, maybe? Yes, no? 4,000. Not bad. I will take it. Fighting while swimming is... Yeah, right? The logic is just impeccable here. Ela gained a fighter level. Another 1 point for his Kyurjutsu. Chunk leveled. Everybody's leveling. That's Skullduggery up. Like, Chunk is catching up on levels purely because, like, on Kyurjutsu levels with Ela, purely because Ela keeps getting the one fucking skill point for his Kyurjutsu. Which is probably because he's taking fighter levels right now, if I had to guess, but... Psionic, so that's Theosophy. All right. So theoretically, he should be able to get his Mind Break spell. Yes! Psionic Blast. Also Spooks. All right. We are probably going to lose Rove as I try to get back to land here. I did not mean to search. Stop that. Go back. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Half the party's dead. Ela's mega poisoned. Let's see what our assets are here. I know we have resurrection potions in this party somewhere. We have a resurrection potion in this party. Less than ideal. Yeah, that's drowning. Drowning you just die. That's a reload, sadly. All right, and keep in mind, this is with maxed out swimming skill. We cannot get any better at swimming than we are right now. So this seems like just there is an encounter here. We have no discourse beyond getting ganked by jellyfish and piranhas. These things got hit points on them, too. That worries me. Ooh. That damage, though. Yeah, okay, we have AoE, it's doing work. Row's getting eaten alive. The front row is being real bad. By the front row, I mean everyone that isn't Swell, because he's the only one that's using a weapon that isn't shit. Kill this one. Yes. Okay. I have more experience. That was actually an easier fight too. Hell yeah. Maybe we'll get better skill rolls here. Not looking like it, though. Ah, he got 2 points. All right. I'm actually going to start giving him points in one and dagger, because I think that Bastillard he's fighting with in his offhand is actually a dagger. Two thief levels this time, damn. It's Skullduggery. And a ranger level, holy shit! Acid splash. So bad. Have sushi master, Eli? Yes. He's preparing that fish expertly. When he's not drowning. Okay. Back. Left. Oh. We need to cast stamina. Man, do I regret not taking rest all on gold leaf. Purely because this is obnoxious as fuck. I just want to get back to the land where we started so that I can save. Just let Ela drown because it's funny. Okay. Oh. Or Goldleaf just drowns, even though she had plenty of stamina, but hey, you know, video games. Good lord, where's that potion of resurrection at? Use it. Goldleaf. Save. Nap. Good god. Oh, hey, birds. That's okay. Rove's awake. And I was hoping we'd be able to putter about on this river a little bit, but the game is just letting me have none of that. Okay, people are awake. These are just basic ravens, so we should be able to just beat the crap out of them, I think. Not worried. Yeah. 128 experience points. Oof. All right. Save again and rest. No penetration as a Ravenclaw swell. Ravens just aren't high enough level to penetrate, man. Experience for that one. Shit. Blow it all in one place. Come on. Get that mana back. There we go. The resting is so much better in this one. Holy shit. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, there's no quick way to get out. So let's... So is there... There's not land over here either. Exploratory drownings. That sounds so terrible. Wait, there's something out. Yeah, there's something out here, but there is no way. All right, yeah, we're not gonna be able to do anything out here, sadly. I thought this was the chunk of river where we could actually get out and do some spelunky and find some goodies, but apparently we just are too bad. Naturally, I blame the front row. Because, I mean, look at them. The only one that with any value is wielding a Holy Avenger right now. Like I said, though, like, the levels are coming quick. I think that all three of the front row are 6th level already, so. Exploratory drowning sounds like something the CIA would do while waterboarding. Oh god. I got dark. Okay, so I mean, the other thing that we can do is beat the shit out of some Dark Savant guards. We can check out the... I know my words. There's that statue in the center of town. XP. I want to actually check. How are we looking? 1300, 2000, 5000, 19, 9, 17. Okay. Yeah, the levels are at a pace that I'm... The early game sections of this, like this town and stuff, are actually a much better grinding place, even for multi-classing when you're low level like this, than... You got in Bane of the Cosmic Forge until fairly late in the game. Like, the good grinding spots in Bane of the Cosmic Forge are, like, once you're on the River Styx. Turk Ralik. Turk. Maybe Tracker. Druce! Swell! Peace! He's angry. Alright, I mean, sure, there's one of you. Blinding Flash. Gold Leaf, deal with the other one. I want you to blind it too. Rove? Break his mind. Rove immediately swings Rena Blade. That's worrisome. Well, Swell swings the Avenger and fails. Blinded the Umpani, alright. Sonic Blast, 14 damage. And he's insane! Hell yeah, I missed that spell. Swell should not talk to people at all. Like, so there's the thing with this, is we have the diplomacy skill, and that affects a lot of how NPCs react to you. But the other thing that affects how NPCs react to you is your character's karma. And Swell has a fucking karma of one. And the manual's like, you want karmas in all various areas. High is good and low is good. It depends on the NPCs you're talking to. And it's like, that's no help. At all. But it's all we got to go with. Let's try... Stink Bomb? Gold Leaf coming in with the Make Wounds. Rove. Just energy blast and conserve your spell points. He does hang out with Rove. That would, yeah. Breaking minds, yes. The mind breaking thing is definitely a fetish. Rhinos with trumpet guns. Yeah, I know, right? Like the shitty old. They apparently they're blunderbusses. He just fired one at us and missed. 46 damage. Holy shit, Swell, I think that's a new record. I'm honestly surprised this dude isn't dead yet. He's putting up a fight. And we have dealt some pretty significant damage to him, I think. Magic missile. Maybe he won't fuck it up. Be nice. I'm gonna have Goldleaf cast Superman on Ela. Rove, magic missile. Missed with a blunderbush. The joke writes itself. Yes. 41 damage. He's probably doing so much damage because the guy is insane, and that's apparently a status effect that, like, probably doubles your damage, and he runs away. God damn it.
This guy's gonna have a bad time. Yeah, 13 damage. I think this guy's blind, so he's gonna be having a bad time. Can you cast Courage or Bravery on the enemies? No, sadly not. Yeah, this guy is blind, so we're all just gonna just completely body him. Assuming anybody can fucking hit. I wanna see Ela start like beheading all the unique NPCs. There we go. I bet you this thing's probably gonna be worth, yeah, some good experience. 4,000. 4,000 experience points for one enemy. So like, you have to multiply that by 6, and that tells you how many experience points that thing was worth. Ganging up on a blind person, that's heroic. Hey. Who in this party is a heroic class? It's just a party of fighters and thieves. There's a ranger and a psionic. None of these people are heroes. We're murder hobos. Ely would do all the diplomatic stuff. He just goes up to somebody and starts purring, and they just don't know what to do, so they start petting him, which makes him purr more. And things get really awkward, and they're just like, what do you want to make him leave? And that's the solution. Ela has more important skills to invest in than diplomacy, though. Notably, Kirijutsu. Okay, so that's a new area. Why invest in diplomacy when you can invest in decapitation? That's my question. So this is where we were. All right, I want to check out this other area back here. See what we've got. Cause permore death. Boo. Hello. From the shadows slithers a 9-foot giant terang known as Shrittis, as menacing and threatening as ever. Have you slain the fame moon? No. No. What need then has Shrittis for you, the Impuni Hunters? All right. He wants something, but I don't know what. I think he wants me to kill another Impuni Hunter. The one that he told us to kill is the one that we were just fighting, but he ran away, so. Two foots. I love these things. Best enemy in the game. Just look at them, they're dumb plants. I don't even know. Sithis, now Slithis. With text that flies by so fast that I can't read it. Oh, these have gotta be like Dandafoots or Bandafoots, whatever the most powerful ones are. Because they survived a round of combat. There, I was gonna say, they're still going too. Holy shit. And damage. Nasty suckers. Gumby foots. Oh no. They look like they taste like spinach. Okay, hey, whatever. Whatever floats your boat. Oh, I'm loving all these high physical skill levels for Chunk, cranking up his skullduggery. Once we max out his skullduggery, it's all going to be going into ninjutsu, because when he's a ninja, ninjutsu, I believe, increases their armor class. Okay, so we have some water. Oh, this might be the river area I was thinking of then. I just know that there's a river area in this where there's some chests that have some goodies in them. Spinach, eggs, cheese, some bacon. Good shit, man. Oh god. They fear at us. I don't know what these bird things are, but they're terrifying Chunk and Goldleaf. Spectral ravens. Alright, that demands magical death. Oh, they blink too. Those guys were mean. Alright, Rove is poisoned.
Spellcasting, why? We have... I don't even know if we have Cure Poison. Yeah, we don't have Cure Poison, so we're gonna have to save and keep an eye on Rove's hit points here. Okay, he's good. We're fine. All good. The nonsense you normally end up thinking about the ketchup flavor. God, ketchup. Pickle sorbet, what the? Oh, man. I don't know. I will try just about anything once, but some of this stuff is like, good God. It's the mustard flavored ice cream. I've heard mustard flavored ice cream is actually good, but no, I'm not a huge mustard fan in general, I guess, anyways. Like, why? Why would you make mustard flavored ice cream? Good God. People, like, I mean, like I said, I respect people that like weird food, but... God. No, holy shit. That is a... First off, that's a lot of experience points, but also I don't think we're gonna live through that fight. Heinz made horseradish ice cream. Ugh. Ugh. Oh, hey, it's jelly stingers, these fucking nightmares. So I think we used fireballs on these guys to good effect. It's a scimitar. Gold leaf, I don't think, yeah, you're not gonna be able to do too much. Can you blind him, maybe? Yeah, that's true. Sweet mustard is tasty. That's a very fair point. I hadn't thought about it. Like, yeah, because like when I think mustard ice cream, I'm thinking like plain yellow mustard. And like that as ice cream to me just sounds terrible. Like sweet mustard? Yeah, okay, I can see where you're coming from. Like a good honey mustard is... Spell. We want cure poison. No, we want restful so that we can do cheesy bullshit out on the lakes. Okay, let's have a nappy. So now we know jelly stingers, fire. Easy. We're learning. More foots. Foots for days. Live near Heinz HQ. They do Pickleberg. Can confirm horseradish ice cream. Ugh. Just, ugh. Elefoots, foots, and foots. Yo, dog, I heard you liked foots. Scimitar, why don't you knock some of them unconscious? Rove, nuke some of them. You could try it, but if it's regular mustard taste, bleh, yeah. Yeah, like yellow mustard ice cream to me is just like, oh. It just hits you right in the, I don't even know, just incredibly unpleasant. But yeah, no, I can see like a sweet, like maybe like a sweet brown mustard or something might be okay. Kind of like cucumber lime Gatorade. Yeah. Cucumber lime Gatorade's okay. Seems every year pickle or something creeps in someplace weird. Still can't get over the pickle flavored Mountain Dew. Ugh. Better with gin. My wife actually found supposedly a recipe for Baja Blast, like making your own. Apparently it's blue Powerade, Mountain Dew and Sprite all in equal volume. And it's supposed to taste exactly like Baja Blast. And she said, the next time I'm out shopping, I'm going to get you stuff so you can make it. She's like, all right. I do love me some Baja Blast, but that needs to be a sometimes drink. Like, I know you can get it. I know you can get it in cans. But normally the only time I ever get it is the rare occasion I want to overpay at Taco Bell. Yeah. Like, yeah, I know they sell it at Walmart. I've never seen it in bottles, though, and I can't, like, they, anymore, you're paying, like, at least where I am, New England, admittedly, it's expensive out here, but, like, $7 or $8 for a 12-pack of soda, and I look at that and I'm like, get fucked. AFC has Sweet Peach Mountain Dew. I'm not a big synthetic peach flavor person, but that could be really fucking good. I too love mixing sodas. Absolutely. Hey, fighter level 7. See, we're already nearing the point where we're gonna be able to multi-class back into useful classes. Ela will get his murder swords back. And the killing spree will once more continue. Alright, there's Swell's next level of spells. He didn't learn any of this level because he's still a fighter, but every little bit helps. Some lovely flavors I've seen on Amazon, like ranch. Oh, that's, God, Jones Soda did that, like, where they had, like, a bunch of years with really weird flavors. They had, like, the Thanksgiving packs where you could get, like, turkey and mashed potatoes flavored soda. It's, like, total meme shit for, like, food reviewers on the internet to spurg out over and be like, hey, watch my video as I gag drinking turkey flavored sugar water. Just like, fuck off. It's just a decided lack of land out here. Alright. Old Leaf. Give us that restful. It's a lot of mana. That did like nothing, Gold Leaf. You've doomed us all. This is your fault. Restful is like the healful spell. It's terrible. Let's quit. Let's reload. We'll just stick to land and see if we can't follow this up anywhere. Hello, Ratkin Rogues. We're here to kill the ever-living god out of you. I hope you don't mind. No. Psionic Blast. Ruined their minds. Club Soda is a good base for DIY. Yes. When it comes to DIY stuff, we actually got a soda stream, and that thing is great. Like, you can put just about anything in that, and it's turns into something interesting. Have a Grandpa Joe's candy store here. They have sweet corn soda, ew. Garlic soda, ew. Pickle soda, ew. God. The novelty shit. Gasoline-scented candles. Man, I don't even know. There's got to be a market for it, though. Good chat connection keeps borking itself. I am sorry to hear that, Boyle. Cough syrup in the soda stream? I mean, if you want, like, cheap, shitty cough syrup, you could do that. Basically, the soda stream just lets you make carbonated water, and then you add, you know, whatever syrups your flavor, like, your choices. But you can add other things to it instead. Like, instead of adding soda streams, you know, soda syrups, you can add, like, there's, like, you know, water additives. You can get, like, Kool-Aid water additives. You can add stuff like that and make, like, cherry Kool-Aid flavored soda. And, like, stuff like that's pretty good. Sausage water. Good God. Carbonated fireball whiskey. Like weed? I mean, if you can get weed into a liquid form, I suppose, yes, you could add it. If you're one of those people that can't do anything in life that doesn't involve weed, yes, that can be Yet another gateway for your coping mechanism of choice.
Boring beetles. Sausage water. God damn it, Ela.
I can just imagine you, like, with a sausage grinder, like, grinding up sausage and then, like, pressing the juice out of it into the carbonated water. Ugh. Do you want to drink grass? I mean, yeah. You want to juice some grass? Sausage slurpee? You guys are fucked up. There's something wrong with y'all. Will it blend? Will it soda stream? Oh, man. Oh, man. Aran River, Munkarama Bridge. The sign appears to be out of date, for it is quite plain that there is no bridge which crosses the river here. There is, however, a long steel cable which has been drawn taut between two trees on each side of the river, and perhaps there's a way to make use of it in some fashion. From somewhere nearby on the riverbank, you hear the slurred sounds of someone singing, or at least trying to. After a moment, you decide it's not singing, it's crooning, badly out of tune, and you're sure the mysterious minstrel is either completely deaf, trying to scare some animal, or is dying in great pain. Finally, you spot the wailing figure rising from the bank, and after brushing the leaves and dirt from his robes, he turns in your direction, mercifully desisting in his aria and something else. Boil some hot dogs, emulsify some mustard into it, carbonate it, and sell it to idiots on the internet. Good God. I was, when the bridge was still here, only now I still am, but there isn't one. I mean, oh, never mind. How may I help you, good brothers? Who are you? Are you traveling to the holy city of Munkarama? No? I suppose it's none of my business. Be you wanting to cross the river? No. Brother Schober, alright. Can I just, like, leave if I run? What? Let me just turn around and walk away from this fucking dipshit. Oh my God. Friend, bye. Bye. Something foul afoot. Alright. Cut off their faces. What? You have a few reminders of virtues of the right path, you know what I mean. I hate that this text scrolls so fast, because I would love to be able to actually read it. Alright, we'll try trucing with this guy. He attacks us. Good God. Highest quality conversation system. Hey guys, you want to cross the river? I'm gonna kill you! And then Ela just crits him and his head just flies off. I'm silencing him because I know he's a spellcaster, because they all are. Got him! Get fucked, buddy! You guys wanna rent a room in my inn? And then immediately starts a fist fight. Pulls out shotgun. Is my clock speed too high? That is the issue, yes, but no matter how low I turn it, that still happens. Thanks, buddy, we got a horn. Who has identify? Is that Rove, I think? This is an instrument. Alright, no, just leave everything else. Horn. Wait, who has identify? I know somebody in this party does. Alright, gold leaf. Yeah, like, what the issue is that you're seeing messages on the stream chat that doesn't show up in the chat log. Okay, yeah, I see that too. I don't know. Angel's tongue. We already have one! Drop it! Ghosts!
Alright, well, at least now we don't have to deal with him being the dipshit anymore. That counts for something. Oh, wait, no. It's Schober's ghost. What? Now you'll pay! What the fuck? Now you'll all pay! Come to me! What the fuck? What? This dude's summoning like fucking swole porn here. Go to bed, Lysandus, you fuck. Oh my god. He picked the fight and I'm being punished for it. Because I can't just walk away. Alright, sure. I'm gonna have Goldleaf try and just dispel him then, I guess. And Rove. Just magic missile these guys. I don't know what the fuck these things are. Unaffected by a dispel, alright. Alright, he silences. That's less than ideal. 19 damage, oh boy. Cast Ice Ball. Oh yeah, there's no way. Yeah, there's no way this fight's a loss. Okay, that's I think Twitch is fucked. You're having the opposite happening. Yeah, if it's on anybody's end, I have dropped approximately 168 frames this entire stream, which according to OBS is 0.0% of the stream. So yeah, any buggeries on Twitch's side as per protocol. The internet's actually been surprisingly stable this year, now that I think about it. All right, so that's where that fucking douchebag is. Noted. We'll just swim around. I'm somewhere nearby on the riverbank. Oh my god. Bye. He climbs up into a tree. Wait, what? Apparently the game takes me saying bye to him as me just being like, yes. Bye. No. What the fuck? No matter what I say, the game's just like, no, you're going to say yes to everything he says, no matter what. And if you try to just leave, he's going to attack you. D.W. Bradley! Okay, so we can't use the road there, in essence. Okay. That's fine. This game. Everyone hates you since you're allied with the Trank. Yes, that does affect things. Absolutely, Ela. That does affect, especially with, I think, the Umpani. Like, that's going to make allying with them much more difficult. Oh, is this? We're being attacked by nymphs. Geisha nymphs. They're probably going to do what sirens did to us in the other one. Excuse me. So I want to kill these guys with like maximum violence. Just fiery death everywhere. Death by snoo snoo. Esoteric dance. That's the thing, is like we've been completely ignoring what the Trang wanted us to do. But it doesn't matter because video games. Okay, that was nasty purely because they have AoE spells. Good XP though, holy hell. Heal with a thunderous 2 points in Kirijutsu. Rove continuing to slowly improve. No. Oh, is this another level? No. Not another level spells until 75. Oof. What's spooks do?
least they wore clothing. That's true. I don't know how much nudity is in this one. I don't think it's nearly as much, if any. Mental spells. Spooks. Conjuring is an illusion so terrifying it may scare creatures away, cause them to cower in fear, or otherwise reduce their capacity to fight well. See, when a sentence starts that it's an illusion so terrifying, what it needs to proceed to then is that shit dies, not that things get scared. They're so scared. I'm gonna take sane mind for the inevitable insanity that we're going to be dealing with. Let's have some nap time. Very great explanation. Yeah, that's why I've got the website open. Mental spell spooks. Okay, so according to this, it literally all it does is fears things for between 4 and 28 rounds, depending on level. It does, however, affect all enemies. That could theoretically be kind of useful. Depending on how effective it is, you'd be able to, you know, at least fuck things up. Oh my god. This is not a good fight. Scimitar, fireball, gold leaf. I don't know what whipping rocks is gonna do, but we'll try it. Rove, fireball. Yeah, make sure he's on the second group. How many enemies are affected by fear? It doesn't look like there's an actual fear spell. Or do you mean like regarding how many enemies are resistant to fear? I have no idea. I'd have to go digging through crap. I'm sure, realistically, probably a fair amount. Outside of boss fights, these games tend to be pretty good about letting you just absolutely fuck things with status effects. In Wizardry 8 in particular, like, that game, I'm not going to say it's trivialized by status effects, but they let you get away with so much with status effects in that game that if you don't use them, you are like shooting yourself in the foot pretty hard. This fight is going to be worth a shitload of XP if everyone survives. Rove. Yeah, resistance-wise, I would imagine most things. Oh, I am so glad I healed him because, oh, there goes Scimitar. Failboating and killing himself, which necessitates a reload. I love video games. How dare you try to have your characters act in combat? You tried to do something in a fight? Guess what? Get fucked. Dinkle wisps. Doubt. Chili chicken, oh hell yeah. Honestly, with buffs, debuffs in most games is that they're either too strong or useless. Yeah, it's kind of hard to get like a middle ground there. Dinkelberg! This is where I'd put my samurai if I had one. Instead, we just have Lanneray. But we love him nonetheless. Still gaining levels. Ooh, good. Why am I putting it in pills and stabs? Nice. Gonna be getting to be time to multi-class again here before too much longer. Have some oratory, Scimitar. You need it so that you're not killing my party anymore. Looks like you get to learn charm. Save. Nap. God. I love how, like, we've been... two streams in, roughly 5 hours, 5.5, maybe going on 6. We have done nothing involving plot so far. We're just exploring.